J. Warner Wallace has spent his life looking for clues. As a detective, he's cracked the toughest cases. And one day, he began an investigation into one that would change his life forever.
Jim Warner Wallace is a seasoned cold case homicide detective who comes from three generations of law enforcement. He's also been featured repeatedly on NBC's Dateline. For many years, Jim was an atheist. But in 1996, he began to search for proof of God's existence, the same way he would search for clues at a crime scene. His investigation led him to an unwavering conclusion. Jim shares his forensic evidence in his book, God's Crime Scene, to make a compelling case in favor of a divine creator.
Well, J. Warner Wallace is here with us now. It's a fascinating book. It's richly illustrated, and it's a cold case investigator. And tell me about it. You spent your life doing this. What do you look for? You're a cold case. You've got the dead body lying there, and what do you go from there?
Well, not every death scene, you know, is a crime scene, because there are four ways to die. So the first thing that we typically do is decide, well, do we have a murder here? Or is it a natural, an accidental, or a suicide?
Okay.
Or is it actually a murder? And one of the tricks we use, and I've been doing it for years, is something I call an inside or outside the room kind of a game.
Okay.
Where we simply ask, can I explain all the evidence that's in this room by staying in the room? If I can, it's probably not a murder. So, for example, if I have a death scene and I've got a pistol laying next to the victim, but the pistol belongs to the victim, it was his all along, and it's got his DNA and fingerprints on it, maybe there's even a note that's in his writing, well, this is probably not going to be there's no sign of any intruder.
All right,
now, on the other hand, if it's not his pistol and there's foreign DNA and there's even like bloody footprints leading out of the room, well, now I can't explain the stuff in the room by staying in the room. I've got to go outside the room for best explanation. That's the approach we take, is the inside. So I thought, well, could you take the same approach with the universe? If there are eight pieces of evidence that we identified in the universe, can I explain those by staying in the room of the natural universe, or is the best explanation outside the room? And that's what God's crime scene is.
We'll start at the inside of the room. What did you find out?
Well, I think there are, you know, if I was working you as a suspect in a case, and all I had was a witness who said they saw you there, that would be good. But if I had physical evidence to add to that, and maybe some statements you made and some behaviors that were observed, now I'd have different categories of evidence that would point to the same reasonable inference. Well, I think there are four categories of evidence, eight pieces, very, very different cosmological evidence, the beginning of the universe, the fine-tuning of the universe, biological evidence, the origin of life, the appearance of design and biology, mental evidence, consciousness, and free agency.
Let's go to this cosmological. In other words, there's no question, as you look at the universe, it had to have a beginning. Is that the answer? It had to begin.
And all the science demonstrates it. This isn't my claim. You know, Genesis 1 claims the same thing.
Yeah.
That's not really my claim as a theist, as somebody who believes in God, to begin with. That's the claim of even the atheists who are scientists, who are looking at several things they see, the second law of thermodynamics, you know, the background radiation they see in the universe. There's lots of evidence we talk about that points to the fact that all space, time, and matter began from nothing. And when I say nothing, I don't mean anything spatial, anything material, anything temporal. So what is it?
So somebody had to come from outside the room to make it happen.
That's right. I think the best, automatically, we're already outside the room of the natural universe just to explain the room itself.
How about life itself?
Well, I think the origin of life studies have been really interesting to watch over the last, say, 30 to 50 years. And as you look at all the attempts at explaining where life could originate in the universe, where it could originate on planet Earth, you see the problems you find. And basically, it's because physics cannot get life started. It turns out that the thing that you really need to direct the formation of life is information that we see in the genome and the DNA. And the problem we have is that, as Stephen C. Meyer says, is you cannot find a single example in the history of the universe in which information has ever come from anything other than intelligence. You can't get information like you see in DNA from physics. There are no natural properties of law that can get this.
Well, you've got, in DNA, you've got the equivalent of a library of, several thousand books with close typed print. And they say that came out of natural selection, you know, when evolution brought it about. Evolution couldn't do that.
Well, you just need to show me the mechanism. Now, again, as a detective, I'm always saying, well, what's the data?
Yeah.
And then how do we interpret the data? So be careful. Science doesn't say anything. Scientists do. And the evidence doesn't say anything. The jury interprets this evidence to determine what the best inference is.
You know, theists... And science don't really have to be at odds with one another, do they? It's the interpretation of the scientific data that's the problem, right?
Yeah, when I pick a jury, I'm always concerned about their bias coming in. What are their presuppositions?
Okay.
If I'm somebody who excludes the supernatural before I even begin, there's no room for anything outside of natural forces, natural causes. Well, then guess what? When I interpret this data, I'm going to find a way to make it fit into my presupposition as a naturalist. Now, that's the question. Do we have to restrict ourselves? If that's the case, how does naturalism explain even your consciousness, this immaterial experience of consciousness and free agency? How does naturalism explain these eight pieces of evidence in the room? Mm-hmm. And that's the burden, Pat, that's on all of us. They say, well, you Christians and you theists, you have the burden of proof. Not really. Yeah. All of us see the same eight pieces of evidence, and we all share the burden. Can your worldview explain these eight pieces?
And theirs don't. Folks, I wish we had. This is fascinating. It's called God's Crime Scene. Where can people get this book?
Well, you can get it in all the booksellers across the planet, you know, of course. And, of course, my website is coldcasechristianity.com.
Coldcase Christianity, God's Crime Scene. It's a tremendous book, and it's been highly endorsed because it is just so interesting and so full of data that you need to know. The cosmology that says God is there by a leading forensic detective, God's Crime Scene. God bless you. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Pat, for having me. I so appreciate you.